Okay, so today let us start this class. I hope you are able to see the screen. Now, today, as you have already studied yesterday, the concept of force, then movement, and their applications, then what is a coplanar force, also we have studied. So, today let us study the other different types of forces also. Clear? So, basically, whatever that we are studying, okay, this will be helpful for you in the coming classes when all the chapters we are going to study. Got it? So these concepts you should never forget. Okay, so yesterday we have studied which force?
Sir,
Coplanar.
pull
Pull
force, force and push force.
force and coplanar force.
Okay, no, this different types of forces let us study. So, what is a coplanar force? Coplanar force is
System forces.
forces, more than one
System
force
of
acting on
forces.
the same
The system of forces. System of forces means more than one force is called as system of forces. System of forces acting on the same plane. Acting on the same plane is called as coplanar force. Clear? So today let us study, as you know that what is this coplanar forces, the diagram also I have said you yesterday. Assume that this is which plane I have drawn here. This is a circular plane, is it? This is a circular plane. In this circular plane, you see I have drawn many forces here. Now this is one force, any direction, okay. And you know that force is a vector quantity, it has a magnitude as well as direction. And what is the unit of force?
Sir, mass into acceleration due to gravity.
Acceleration, that is kg meter per second square, or the other thing is Newton. Okay. So these are the forces which you can see here. So F1 is the name I have given here. And let us take this as F2. Let us take this as F3. And this you give it name as any number of forces you can put on this particular circular plane. So all these forces are acting in the same plane or not? So this is called as coplanar forces. Got it? So the next type of force we'll study is collinear force. Collinear forces. Okay. So collinear, as the name suggests here, you can see collinear forces means the name here you can see over here is, what did I underline here? Linear. What is linear? Linear means, what is linear? Acting, it is line, okay. LINEAR. So the first four words are what? LINE, line. So you can remember in this way, the system of forces acting in the same line. Acting in the same line. Is this clear? Now this is a line or not? This is a horizontal line which I have drawn it here. Okay, this is one horizontal line. Okay, this is one inclined line I have drawn. This is one vertical line I have drawn. Okay, now let me draw different types of forces. This is on this particular line, I'm drawing some forces here. The total, how many forces I have drawn?
Sir, force, four force,
Four forces.
four.
All are in same direction.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
But in this line, you see, both are opposite. Two forces acting in opposite direction. Here, you see, I'm drawing two forces in same direction, but one force is
Upper
opposite direction. So here, let us give some names to this. F1. is F2. Total how many forces? Four forces. So here also you can put any number, so number here. So this is your F1 and F2. F1, this is F2, F2. Okay. So here all the forces are acting in the same line or not? All are acting in the same line. So all these forces are which forces? Collinear forces. All these forces are collinear forces. So this is the second type of force. I hope you understood, all of you. Here also the forces are opposite. F1 and F2 are opposite to each other. But these forces are also acting in the same line or not? So these are also called collinear forces. Here you see two forces are acting in downward direction and F3 force is acting in upward direction. So here, but still the three forces are acting in same line. So these are called as which force? Collinear force. So what is a collinear force? The system of forces acting in the same line. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Okay. So next, third force is, please spell it. What is this?
Co-incurrent.
Concurrent forces.
Concurrent force.
Concurrent forces. So let us study what are concurrent forces. So by seeing the diagram, can anyone give the answer or definition? Very simple one. Total how many forces here are there?
Eight force.
Very good. So total how many forces? Eight
Eight
forces.
forces.
Eight force.
So let us name one by one. You can number it randomly also, there is no issue in that. Total. Here, who will say the definition? It is
Sir, the
passing through
system
the system of forces
of many forces.
passing through a
Point.
common point. Common point. Passing through a common point. Okay. That is the definition. So all the forces are passing through same point or not? And what is that point?
Yes, sir.
That point is known as O. Okay, I have named it as O. So the system of forces passing through a common point. This is known as concurrent forces. So these three forces, do you have any doubts? First one is coplanar forces, the system of forces acting in same plane. Next is collinear forces, the system of forces acting in the same plane, sorry, same line. Okay, so the directions is not necessary, they should be in the same direction. Here it is same direction. Here they are both opposite directions. Here two are in, say, one direction and the other is in opposite direction. This is called collinear forces acting in same line. Next is concurrent forces. a system of forces passing through a common point. You see, all the forces are passing through a common point. Okay, so all these forces, so these are called as which force? These are called as concurrent forces. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Now,
yes, sir.
These three forces are very important forces: collinear forces, coplanar forces, and concurrent forces. Now, let us try to learn some more forces by joining these three forces. Joining these three forces means by joining the names of these three forces, like what did I write here? Collinear coplanar forces. What is this?
Collinear coplanar
forces. It's very, very simple. If you are able to remember the definitions of these two, I hope at this point of time you have remembered this. The definition is very simple. Collinear coplanar. Collinear coplanar means what? You can easily say this. The system of forces, yes, acting
in the same plane,
yes, in the same line,
and the same plane.
All only combination of both, the system of forces acting in the same line and same plane. Okay, so it is nothing but these two diagrams also. You can, let me use the same diagram, that is a circle. And what will be the other diagram?
So, B forces are in line.
Yeah. Circle and a line. Not necessarily it should be horizontal or vertical. And here I am drawing the forces. Okay, any direction, whatever comes to your mind at that particular point of time. So this is F1, this is F2, and this I'll take it as F3. Now here you can see all the forces are acting in same line or not. They are acting in same line as well as they are acting in the same plane. Here, which plane I have taken? I have taken circular plane. You can take circular plane, you can take this triangle also, you can take, okay, rectangle, square, anything, whatever you want, you can take as a plane. Got it? So this is your, which type of force? Collinear coplanar forces. Collinear coplanar forces. Collinear coplanar forces. Okay. Next. What is non-coplanar forces? Opposite to that. What is coplanar forces? The system of forces acting in the same plane. What is non-coplanar forces?
The system of forces
acting in the opposite.
The system of
not
forces.
Not in the same plane.
Yes, system of forces acting in the, simply you can write, acting in the?
Different planes.
Different
planes. Now this is a case of like you say 3D object. Okay, so let me draw this. What is this that I have? I am drawing.
It's a box.
A cube. Looking like a dice. Okay. It has how many faces?
Six faces.
Very good. So in these six faces, what I am doing is, one force I am putting in this face, the other force I am putting it in the opposite face. Here I am putting one face, one force. So all forces are acting in different planes or not?
Yes.
In different directions also. Okay. So all these forces will come under what? Which force?
Non-coplanar
forces. So this is your F4. And this is here, F3. All forces are acting in different planes. So you have total six planes in your room or not? In your cubical room, you have your how many planes? Six planes. So as yesterday I was speaking to you, in the cubical room where you're sitting, there are four walls, you can see. And the roof is there and the floor is there. So total six planes. In all the six planes, you draw different lines in the form of forces, okay? In this form, you draw it with the help of chalk piece. So all those forces which you have drawn on all the four walls, roof as well as floor, will come under which type of forces? It is coming under non-coplanar forces. Is this clear? The non-coplanar forces are system of forces acting in different planes. Okay. You understood this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The next is coplanar and what is this?
Concurrent
forces.
Concurrent forces. What is coplanar and concurrent forces? Coplanar concurrent is easy. You know it. We'll read. System of forces.
Acting in the same plane, passing through the common point.
And passing through the
common point.
Common point. Okay. So, coplanar concurrent forces, it is a system of forces acting in the same plane and passing through the common point. Suppose this is your square plane I have drawn here. So, in this square plane, what I have done is, I have drawn only very simple. Okay, why I am drawing horizontal? You can draw in this way also, like this. Okay. So, total how many forces are passing here? There may be a doubt, sir.
Four forces.
In the previous diagram, you have drawn all the forces are pull force or push force? All the forces are pull force or push force? See it.
Pull, sir.
Very good. Pull
force.
Pull. It is away from the point or not? It is away from the point. That means you are pulling it. Okay. When it is towards the point, this force which I have drawn here, you see, this force which I am drawing now, this is which force?
Push force.
It is push. And this is your pull force.
Pull.
With respect to this point I am talking about. Okay. So here total how many forces are there? The total four forces are there here. So this is your F1. This is your F2. This is your F3. And this is your F4. So total these four forces are there. All are passing through common point and they are acting in the same plane. So this is called as coplanar concurrent forces. Any doubts? Coplanar concurrent forces.
Has it a pull force came there last? You thought about Hello China.
Which one? This one, F2.
सर जो बॉक्स भीतर जो अच्छे एरो को रखो जो फोर्स को रखो से तो तीर चिन्ह मैंने दिया है मैंने से तो ठेलो चिन्ह से तो टारो ना ही
सी हियर विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू दिस पॉइंट एफ टू एंड एफ थ्री आर विच फोर्स पुल फोर्स एंड एफ वन एंड एफ फोर आर पुश फोर्स अंडरस्टूड क्लियर
हाँ
Not all are pull. Here all are pull force, I'm saying. Here in this diagram, all are pull forces. And all are pull forces with respect to this particular point I'm talking. Okay, with reference to that point. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Coplanar concurrent. So next is... Non-coplanar... Yes, non-coplanar concurrent forces. This is also possible. Okay, you see, these are all basic applications in your day-to-day life. You are seeing is clear. Non-coplanar concurrent forces. So, what is that definition? You can write
the system of forces acting in
the system of forces.
Acting in a different plane.
Yes, acting in different
planes. Acting in the different point.
Acting in different planes. But?
And passing through the different point.
It is concurrent.
Passing through the common point. Common point.
Common point. Okay. This let us see. This particular non-coplanar, non-concurrent, you can, after seeing this diagram, you can see it or you can imagine it in your respective cubicle rooms where you're sitting also. Just let me show you. Again, here I'm drawing a cubical box. So, what is non-coplanar? Not acting in the same plane. It is not acting in the same plane. Total, how many corners are there in your room? Eight corners are there or not? You see?
Yes, sir.
Eight corners.
In your room also. Eight corners are there or not? Yes, eight corners are there. Now, this particular force, any edge of your room, you understand the edge? In your front side, there is a wall. Your right side, there is a wall. The coincidence of both the walls is called as edge. Okay. All these are different edges or not?
Yes, sir.
Are you seeing this, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Now, this line which I am talking about, this line, it is a force, okay?
Yes.
So, let me write first, then I'll make you understand. This is F1. This is F2. And this is. So here, all these four forces. Now, here, all these forces are passing through common point or not? F1, F2, yes. F3. Yes? But F1 is belonging to a different plane or not? F1 is belonging to a different plane. F2 is belonging to a different plane. F3 is belonging to a different plane. So this is non-coplanar concurrent forces. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Similarly, you can draw this also. This is one force. This is one force and this is the other force. All are of different planes or not? So all the eight points, corner points which you are seeing, you can show it in this diagram. Got it? So this is one force, this is one force, this is one force. All are passing through common point, but they are from different planes. Got it? So this is non-coplanar concurrent forces. Non-coplanar concurrent forces. Okay. So this is all about different types of forces. Got it? Next. Let us try to understand the different concepts of equilibrium of rigid bodies. Different concepts of equilibrium of rigid bodies. Okay. So before that, you should know what is a rigid body. Clear? And remember, in this thing you should remember, in engineering mechanics, all bodies, what is a body? It can be a living body or non-living body. It can be anything. Clear? You know what is living body and non-living body. In engineering mechanics, all bodies are assumed to be which bodies?
Rigid bodies, sir.
Rigid bodies. Then you should know what is a rigid body. Okay. Yeah. But practically, there are no rigid bodies. Practically, no body is a rigid body. Understand? Clear? But in mechanics, we are assuming that all are rigid bodies, but practically, you won't find any rigid body in this universe. Got it? Then what is a rigid body? Rigid body is that body. Rigid body is that body where on the application of force, where on the application of force, there will be no there will be no
deformation.
So what is deformation? Let us first understand. Deformation means a change in shape and size. What is deformation?
Change in shape, size.
Okay, etc. Very simple example I'm giving you. Every day you might have, most of the time you might have done this experiment, elastic rubber band. Okay, elastic rubber band, when you're stretching it, its length is changing or not? The length of the elastic rubber band, when you're applying which force on the elastic rubber band?
Pull force,
very good. Pull force, when you're applying, what is happening to the length of the rubber band? Very good. Length of the rubber band is increasing. What is happening to the diameter? You take circular rubber bands. You understand circular rubber bands? Mostly these girls use. Hair bands. The girls, they are using.
Yes,
it is a circular cross section or not?
Yes, sir.
That when you stretch it, so what is happening to the length? Somebody said length is increasing. What is happening to the diameter? Length is increasing. Very good. What is happening to the diameter? You understand diameter, all of you?
Decrease.
Very good. Length will, you can do this experiment in your house also. Okay. A rubber band, you take it, which is circular in cross section. You try to pull it with your two fingers or two hands. Length of that particular rubber band is increasing, but the diameter is decreasing. Got it? Now, that is, the shape is changing or not? Shape is changing, size is changing, length is changing, diameter is decreasing. That means there is a deformation or not? There is a deformation. Now, when you leave it, now you don't apply the force. After stretching it, you leave it. What is happening? Again,
when
it is coming.
To the
yes,
position.
Again, it is coming back to its normal position or not?
So yes, sir.
Bodies are called as elastic bodies. Which bodies?
Elastic.
Those bodies are called as elastic bodies. Now let us do one more experiment. You take a small iron wire, very thin iron wire, which you use in your house for drying your clothes in the terrace. Are you using or not? Those iron wires, you try to pull it with your two hands, very thin iron wires. Clear? It will expand or not? The length will increase or not? Now you release the load. Will it come back to its normal position?
No, sir.
No, sir.
So those are inelastic bodies. Those are
inelastic
bodies. Then, sir, what are rigid bodies? Remember, rigid bodies are those bodies where there is no kind of any deformation. No deformation means, you see, as I already told you, practically rigid bodies are not possible. Okay. You cannot say no deformation here. You have to say
no deformation, sir.
What you should write here?
Negligible.
Okay. Deformation can never be zero. When you're sitting on a sofa set, what is happening? The sofa set is getting compressed or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So when you're sitting on a chair, the same thing is happening. The chair is compressing.
No, sir.
No, sir.
No. But actually, when your weight is there on the chair, there is some deformation is taking place, but we are not able to see. In case of sofa, the deformation easily you can see or not?
Yes, sir.
Easily you can see. But in case of chair, there is a deformation, but that is negligible deformation. And that deformation you cannot see with your naked eye. With your eye, you cannot see it. So those bodies where there is a negligible deformation, negligible means we don't consider this deformation in which subject? In engineering mechanics, this deformation is not considered. Sir, where it is considered, there is again a different subject. Mechanical diploma people will learn in third semester. Mechanics of solids. Their deformation is considered. But in engineering mechanics subject, the deformation, all bodies are assumed to be which bodies? They're assumed to be rigid bodies. I hope you understood what is rigid body, all of you.
Yes, sir.
Okay, you have understood rigid bodies. So next is equilibrium, concept of equilibrium. Sir, what is actually this equilibrium? Let me draw this particular diagram. So what did I write here? Equilibrium. Any idea what is equilibrium?
Imbalance.
Just equilibrium means what?
Sir, influence or balanced?
Not imbalance. It is a state of balance. It is a state of balance. Now you are in which? Are you in imbalance position or balance position? Now presently balance. You all are sitting or standing?
Sir, balance position.
You all are sitting, or maybe somebody is standing and listening the class. When you are standing in a particular place, you are in which state?
Balance
state. So the actual meaning of equilibrium is
state of balance.
Yeah. A state of balance is equilibrium. So how that balance is created? Why you are in balance position? Can anyone say? Because as I told you, there are many forces are acting on you or not. Gravitational force is acting. Your own weight is called as active force. Suppose you are sitting on a chair. The chair is giving reaction forces. Yes or no? So all these forces, when you add the net force, if it is zero, then you will say that you are in balanced position. Got it? So a state of balance, you can write a state of balance, between which forces?
Opposing forces
or
actions.
Okay. Opposing forces and
actions.
Okay. So it is better, instead of writing this particular, or you can say equal action of opposing forces also, you can say. Clear? So this is called as equilibrium. Now, what is the net force? What are the equilibrium conditions? Which conditions?
Equilibrium conditions.
Okay, so equilibrium conditions for what? Equilibrium conditions for coplanar concurrent forces. What did I write here? Equilibrium conditions for
coplanar concurrent forces.
Yes, please. Wait. Equilibrium conditions of coplanar and concurrent forces. You know what is coplanar concurrent? Coplanar concurrent means system of forces acting in same plane and passing through a
common point.
So in those kinds of, now here, in those kinds of situations, what are the conditions? Clear? And you know that what is coplanar and concurrent forces. What is coplanar concurrent? This is a plane, square plane I have taken. In this square plane, all the forces are coplanar and concurrent or not? You can see here. All the forces are coplanar and
concurrent.
Now all are passing through common point or not? Three forces are, how many forces are pull force? Who will say?
How many forces are pull forces?
See it carefully and answer. How many forces? Three forces are pull force and one force is?
Push force,
that is F4. Okay, passing through a common point O. Got it? So this is a coplanar concurrent force or not? Coplanar concurrent force. Now, sir, what are the conditions? Remember, the conditions here are, there are two conditions. See, in first class I told you mechanics is divided into two parts or not? One is statics, the other is what?
Dynamics.
In statics, you won't find many formulas. Statics problems are solved only by conditions, and very simple conditions. Okay, the conditions are summation of H equal to zero. Because you have written equilibrium condition, na? Equilibrium means what? Net force is zero or not? Static means what? Now you are in which position? Static or dynamic? You are in static position. Equilibrium position. So all the forces acting on you, when you add or subtract, it is zero or not? So summation of H, okay, is zero. And the other, there are two conditions here. And the other condition is summation of V is equal to zero. So these are the two conditions. Then you will ask, sir, what is H and what is V? So H is nothing but, what is this?
Horizontal
forces, and V is
vertical forces.
Vertical. vertical forces. Got it? So all horizontal forces you equate it to zero. All vertical forces you equate it to zero. Those conditions when you are using it, that means those are which conditions? Equilibrium conditions for which forces? Coplanar and
concurrent forces.
Concurrent forces. Coplanar and concurrent forces. Okay. So this is now here there is a sign convention. All of you remember what is the sign convention you have to follow? Sign convention. All of you know that horizontal is which line and vertical is which line. Okay. So what is the sign convention? Let us see. In this particular equilibrium conditions of coplanar and concurrent forces. Now here, this is your horizontal line. In which direction? Let me draw like this. This is your horizontal forces or not?
Yes, sir.
And these are your?
Vertical.
Vertical forces. Then, sir, what is the sign convention meaning? Sign convention means what sign you have to use. Net force, summation means what? Addition and subtraction or not? So, right side is, you know, this is graph, like graph only. Right side is?
Plus.
Positive.
Positive. Left side is?
Negative.
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 Negative. Okay. And upward is positive, downward is
negative.
Negative.
Can you remember? This is very easy. So this is a sign convention that we are going to use in this particular two conditions. Summation of H equal to zero. If a force is in this direction, remember there may be again a doubt. Suppose let me show you one example here. In the small space, I'll show you an example. Now these are the, this is one force, this is one force, this is one force. Horizontal I'm talking, okay? Now can you say which one is, can you write the equation? Suppose this is your F1, this is your F2, please say me the equation, summation equation. This is F3. Who will say? Two forces are in right side arrow, you see. What are the two forces?
Right F1 and F3.
F1 plus F3, F3 minus?
Minus F2.
This is how you write. Okay. F1 plus F3 minus F2. This is the summation of H. Okay. If it is equilibrium, you have to write equal to zero. Any doubts?
No, sir.
Is this
no, clear? Sir.
So don't think that which, in which side it is. You please see the arrow mark. Got it? F3, I have put it in this side, but the arrow mark is in the towards the right side, so it should be positive. Okay. So this is how, similarly for upward and downward also, you should remember. Upward, upward force is positive, downward force is
negative.
And remember, upward vertical force, upward, downward vertical. Then again, there may be a doubt in your mind, sir, every time forces will be horizontal vertical. It can be in this way also or not? Like this I have drawn. It is inclined at an angle or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this I cannot say horizontal. Can I say horizontal? No.
No.
Okay. So that is again a different case. Next class I will say you resolution of forces. So this force I will resolve into two components. One horizontal component, one vertical component. This force also I will resolve into two components. One horizontal component and one vertical component. That concept I will make you learn in the next class, which is very, very important. to solve any problem in mechanics, resolution is very important. Next class, it don't become absent. Okay. So this is all about your equilibrium conditions of coplanar and concurrent forces. Equilibrium conditions of coplanar concurrent forces. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So next. Next is what? Existence of friction. We learn many other concepts are there. I'm giving you the total gist of the subject. Existence of friction and its applications through solution of problems for the above. That means same these, all these concepts of first one and second one will apply while solving the problems of friction. Okay, now what is friction? Any idea what is friction? What is friction? Friction is what actually? Any, who will say? You might have learned in physics. Friction is a force or what?
Friction is also a force.
Friction is a force only. Okay. Now, you are able to sit on your chair. This we'll discuss in detail in the next class. We'll wind up after this. Friction, you are sitting on a chair or not?
Yes, sir.
Are you slipping? Not sleeping. Are you slipping? S-L-I-P. You understand slip?
No, sir.
You're not slipping. Suppose on your chair, I'll put an ice block. You know ice?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Block I'll put. Will you able to sit?
No, sir.
Now, how you are able to sit? Will you able to sit? What will happen? You will slip. Suppose I'll put oil on your chair. Will you able to sit?
No, sir. No, slipping.
You will slip or not? So you are able to sit in a proper position in static or equilibrium due to friction. Okay. And that friction is called as static friction. You put your mobile phone on your table. You put the mobile phone on the floor. Now the force that is developed. Now your mobile phone is on the floor or not? Or on the table or on the book or not? Now the book,
yeah.
You're writing in the notes. The notes you're putting it on the reading table or not? Now when you're putting it on the reading table, is it slipping or is it at a particular position? It is at a particular
position.
Okay. Why? Because there is a friction between your book and table. You're holding pen. You're holding mobile phone. You're holding the pen due to friction. You're holding mobile phone due to friction. Refrigerator is there in your kitchen room. It is moving here and there? No. It is also idle or not at a particular place. It is also due to friction. Got it? Don't think that friction will be developed only when there is a movement of the body. No. When there is a movement of the body, then also friction will be there. Now you can stand up and start walking on the floor in your house. Okay. You are able to walk or not? Now, if friction is developed between your legs and the floor, in which direction? Yes, in which direction friction will be developed? In the opposite direction. If you are moving forward, frictional force is in the backward direction. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Now, suppose, for example, in your total room where you are walking, I'll put the total oil on the floor. What will happen?
We sleep, sir.
Sleep or not?
Yes.
Why you will sleep? Who will say the reason?
Because we are in the foot and the...
Because the friction is less. Because the friction is?
Less.
That is why you will sleep. Sleep. Okay. So, the value of friction is always from 0 to 1. Remember. The value of friction will be from 0 to 1. Okay. That is, we talk it as a coefficient of friction. Clear? So remember, there are two types of frictions. One is your static friction, the other is dynamic friction. Sir, what is the static friction? In case of static friction, okay, the body is at rest. The body, is it moving? The body is at rest. In okay, the friction developed when the body is on the other body. Now, where the friction is developed? Friction is developed between the surfaces. Suppose there is a book on the reading table. The book has a surface or not? And the table has a surface. Are you getting? The book has a surface.
Yes, sir.
And the table has also the surface. Wherever the surface is touching, when you're standing, your legs or your feet, it has a surface or not? And the floor has also the surface. Okay. So the friction is, static friction is developed between the surfaces. Remember, it is developed where? Between the surfaces. Got it? So we'll stop here.
So this is the function name. A open is the function name.